Thank you. What ails thee, dog? This little head might hold the cares of empire. Come, smile upon me, smile. Today of all days I would have thee, Mary. What will our cousin Rupert think of thee?
I care not what our cousin Rupert thinks.
Methought he liked not merriment.
True, Sir Rupert hath his house the Roundhead cause. But if I mistake not, long prayers and short comments will like not him. Be not deceived, our cousin's head is rather long than round. He serves the Parliament.
And serves the times.
In brief, he is not honest.
Honest as times go. If, when he is thy husband, he is true to thee, heed not his politics.
I heed them not, nor his truth either. For he would never be husband of mine.
Pardon, God. I do not care to plague thy pretty head with musty documents and lawyers' quirks. Enough to say that there are those who hold our cousin's title to this fair estate stronger than ours. This marriage puts an end to doubts and questions that have troubled me, and will be grateful to the Parliament, which loves me none too well.
Then thou must wed to please the Parliament.
And me?
From childhood I have striven to please thee, Father.
And thou hast pleased me well.
And I will strive to please thee still in everything save this. Do with me as thou wilt, but spare my heart. I cannot give thee what is not mine own.
Hast thou not yet forgot this youth, whose very name my lips refuse to speak?
Manners, John Manners.
Rutland's younger son. Shame on thee, shame. He is beneath thee, doll. Remember who thou art. Remember that with thee pass all these lands of heaven, and that ancient hall which smiles there as it smiled before the conquest.
I know well who I am. I know from whom I am descended. Nor do I forget their ancient watchword, dread God and honour the king. God I have ever dreaded, and the king I honour, my loving one who sought and served his cause.
If he would but sheath that sword, if he would but pay decent respect to Parliament.
He were a traitor, and not worth my love. Oh, Father dear, turn not from me in anger. Is it sin to love?
Did I speak harshly? Then forgive me, doll. Ever since my son, my only son, died fighting for his country on the sea, thou art my all in all. It breaks my heart to ruffle thee. Go, tell thy lover, if he sheath his sword, if he acknowledge Parliament, which otherwise might forfeit my estate, I will confer with Rupert.
'Twere vain to ask him, 'twere worse than vain.
So be it. Go thy way, and I go mine. Remember only that my word is given, and that a Vernon doth not break his pledge.
I am a Vernon too, and shall I not keep mine?
And in not words with me. No longer do I beg thee, I command.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. these admirable sentiments, amongst others, down with land, down with marriage, down with landlords, down with land. And truly these things are vanities in the abstract. But in the concrete they possess a certain substance. In the abstract, I, Rupert Vernon, am a vanity.
Yea, verily.
But in the concrete, even I possess a certain substance.
Yea, verily.
These brief, preliminary observations will have prepared you for the announcement that I am about to marry and become a landlord.
This is flat blasphemy.
Oh, I was once of that opinion myself. But ever since it had become a question whether my title to this highly attractive residential property is not superior to that of my cousin's present occupant, I have given much attention to the subject, as I may shortly be in a position to keep a carriage myself. I am not quite so persuaded as I was of the necessity of dowry with everybody who indulges in that very harmless luxury.
Odd's fish! Odd's fish!
I fail to see anything odd's fish about it! But then again, our attitude with regard to the land question, is it quite sound? Or is it all sound and no sense?
There be one land, and there be one people. And to the one people, the one land belongeth.
Quite so, my good Barnabas. That is our way of putting it in public. But this is not the hustings. And as private individuals, we know perfectly well that there is more than one people. In fact, there are a great many people. And how is the one land to belong to all of them?
The state is the land. Let the land belong to the state.
The state is the people. Thou art mindful that the occupier should pay his rent to the state.
No rent!
But if the occupier is to pay no rent, then each occupier becomes his own landlord.
Even so.
But in that case, you have more landlords than ever.
So we have to give up.
Nor is the subject of celibacy quite as simple as it appears. Ever since it was arranged that the disputed title to the Haddon estate should be settled by my marriage to fair Mistress Dorothy, my views on this matter also have undergone a change. I feel the need of female sympathy. Nobody sympathizes with us, and when one comes to think of it, why should they?
Why should they?
It must be admitted that we have made ourselves fairly obnoxious of late. We have been particularly busy, and our business has chiefly consisted in interfering with everybody else's. First and foremost, we have abolished the playhouse.
Greatly praised!
Secondly, we have forbidden dance music in all places of public resort.
We have robbed the devil of his best tunes.
But give that ingenious gentleman his due. It has to some extent circumvented us. For by the simple expedient of playing the old 100th in double quick time, he has succeeded in evolving from that venerable air something suspiciously resembling the carnal and pernicious polka. Thirdly, to the end that none shall profane the Sabbath by enjoying it, or shall imperil his soul by ruling his mind, we have shut all museums, parks, and picture galleries, and turned the day of rest into a night of wrath.
Greatly praised!
Fourthly, having deprived the populace of all means of innocent recreation, we have compelled to seek solace in the consumption of strong drink.
Then, verily, have we not closed all its untaverns?
It is true that wholesome, necessary refreshment, either for man or beast, can no longer be procured in an open and honourable fashion. But I can give you my personal assurance that there exist scores of places where any quantity of deleterious concoctions can be obtained in a stealthy and disreputable manner.
Great in praise! Verily, these be notable good works.
But who is the best for the barbers? Who is the better for us?
I will go a step further. Aren't we the better for ourselves?
Oh, sir.
I will ask you another. Are we currently to look upon?
Nay.
Do we not consistently do everything we can to make everybody about us uncomfortable?
Yea, verily.
Do we enjoy ourselves?
All life is sackcloth and ashes.
But our reward is to come.
Are you quite so sure of that? I have no wish to pose as an alarmist. But suppose we are making a bad debt. After a life spent in mortification of the flesh, it would be a growling mortification if it turned out that the flesh was not meant to be mortified. And it would be peculiarly irritating to discover that the flesh was intended to enjoy itself. At the precise moment when we no longer had any flesh to enjoy.
Madam, come up!
Well, Barbara, continue. Let us suppose, for the sake of argument, that Mary did come up. What then?
I have not more to say.
Then hold thy peace and hearken to a wiser tongue than thine.
I heard it said, and trained in bread in many a trusty tongue, how in August met on the parapet of a world of ancient Rome, as the two must find each winter back with an actor confidential, or stroked his nose, which goodness knows, but it isn't at all essential. For every man's is the world in death, and his idiosyncrasy, and much of the
Oh, the world we've got, the best we've had, and that will do me.
Thank you. we'll back ourselves against the hardy wind and the nocturnal cat. And who's one bar? And what will they appoint even at that? Even at that.
The name which is the flag, I am believing.
dog the way.
Good swan. Business form be attended to.
Business? What business?
If thou must ken how many good folk I have made be some, thou say I wasted not time. I'd scarce set fruit upon the book that was to have brought me great healer on. When I beheld to sit, the floor is the very good. A sailor, young in old clothes, a quickling and a cuddling a brawl, lassie on the kids.
Well, perhaps she was his sister.
Aveline's Aveline's, I care me more. Was I to show by and see quickling and a cuddling in a public place? Nah. Say, I just step into shoe and chance to meet his oddly behavior. That's one is to boot.
Any more adventures?
The nest sick that I see was some wee bells, a singing and a dancing and opening. Say, I just ganged up to him, and something in my bare face took the deal who took. I said, hey, here's singing and a dancing, he says. They said they had it. I just took to take Gigi, and when I left them there green with the leaves, I couldn't have fine on my knees, and give thanks to the dead for having made them all, say uncle grief as me.
No doubt, Frankie, no doubt, as a work of art thou dost profit of its infinite credit.
And ye may say that, fine. I said that.
But there is one little matter which rather perplexes me, if I may mention it without offence.
Oot yet.
I have never been able to reconcile thy notorious objection to the costume of court ballet with this exceedingly liberal display of thine own personal attractions.
It is saved from offence by the dignity of the cup.
Which is its dignity? That tobacco pouch there.
Hoots, thou doyle daughter. Thou may lock thy fee, but Scots by hay, nay breeks I won. Nay breeks saw they, I will.
What art thou about, Dan?
A wee. I was...
Yes, Miss Dorothy.
I am rich glad to make thine acquaintance.
So am not I, hands off!
Who to warn? The next is done.
And there is no one looking.
So much the worse.
Say, muckle the better. Thou art a sonsy lassie.
Fire me both, you prisoner of other days, or both be clapped in the stocks.
Hoity-toity, what's a kiss?
Tis no fair a-showing.
Two gods take a thing amiss.
Thus is they invoking.
Hoity-toity, what's a kiss? Kiss and goes my favour.
And when the kiss is more than bliss,
the sweeter is the savour.
Thank you.
idiots they delay their departure unduly. Sooth to say, the position of my poor cousins is pathetic enough, but it behoves them to accept their lot with philosophy, as I do.
Thank you.
counsel with me frankly. His unpopular puritanism will no doubt find a way out of the difficulty.
I was neat at well lasting.
Say,
to warm me up, I just had
a wee threatening wattle demon.
Sickly, I had a wee dropping.
He had one wee dropping.
But some gait I felt more instead of better. Say, I just had another wee drop.
But he had two wee drappies.
But twa wee drappies did not reach the goal.
So thou hadst three.
One. Five. Six.
Wee, that did not just the count.
Well, thou wert fast arithmetic. What then?
I'd fall asleep, and in my sleep got cracking tins. And what do you think I said?
Run! I neither can nor care!
Why never accept of what it sells?
Oh!